Suddenly he pulled the horses up. He passed the reins to Mason and leaped to the ground. It was a stirring moment. The mob advanced, but the movement seemed almost reluctant. It was not the rush of blind fury one might have expected, but rather as though it were due to pressure from behind by those under cover of their comrades in front. Dave moved on to meet them, and those in the buckboard remained deathly still. Mason was the first to move. He had just become aware that Dave had left his revolver on the seat of the vehicle. Instantly, he lifted the reins and walked the horses closer to the crowd. "He's unarmed," he said in explanation to the parson. Chepstow nodded. He moved his repeating rifle to a handier position. Betty looked up. "He'd left that gun purposely," she said. "I saw him." Her face was ghastly pale, but a light shone in her eyes which nobody could have failed to interpret. Mason saw it and no longer hesitated. "Will you take these reins," he said, "and give me your revolver?" The girl understood and obeyed in silence. "I think there'll be trouble," Mason went on a moment later, as he saw Dave halt within a few yards of the front rank of the strikers.